willingness to do this in very challenging times. Mr. Attorney General, we're very appreciative. It's not an easy job, but it's a vitally important one. I so appreciated what you said in your opening statement today, which is what you said in your confirmation hearing. The Attorney General has a unique obligation. He holds in trust the fair and impartial administration of justice. We appreciate that so much. The Democrats have asserted here this morning, and they continue to say in the media, that under your leadership, the Justice Department has become highly politicized. Why is that a totally unfounded allegation?
Because actually what I've been trying to do is restore the rule of law. And the rule of law is, at essence, that we have one rule for everybody. If you apply one rule to A, the same rule applies to B. And I felt we didn't have that previously at the department. We had strayed. And I would just ask people, I'm supposedly punishing the president's enemies and helping his friends. What enemies have I indicted? Who could you point to one indictment that has been under the department that you feel is unmerited, that you feel violates the rule of law? One indictment. Now, you say I helped the president's friends. The cases that are cited, the Stone case and the Flynn case, are both cases where I determined that some intervention was necessary to rectify the rule of law, to make sure people are treated the same. I said, although Stone was prosecuted under me, and I said all along, I thought that was a righteous prosecution, I thought he should go to jail, and I thought the judge's sentence was correct. But the lying prosecutors were trying to advocate for a sentence that was more than twice anyone else in a similar position had ever served. And this is a 67-year-old man, first-time offender, no violence, and they were trying to put him in jail for 7 to 9 years. And I wasn't going to advocate that, because that is not the rule of law. I agree the president's friends don't deserve special breaks, but they also don't deserve to be treated more harshly than other people. And sometimes that's a difficult decision to make, especially when you know you're going to be castigated for it. But that is what the rule of law is, and that's what fairness to the individual ultimately comes to, being willing to do what's fair to the individual.
Amen, and thank you for that. And by contrast, what the previous DOJ did under the previous administration was politicize law enforcement. The Obama-Biden administration sabotaged the Trump transition. They illegally spied on the Trump campaign. They unmasked members of the Trump campaign. They employed aggressive tactics on their campaign officials. Senior FBI officials, we all know on this committee, carried over from the Obama administration, carried on their abuses into the Trump administration and into the whole impeachment scam and all the rest. Let me ask you just one question, because my time is running out. President Obama's Attorney General Eric Holder famously referred to himself as President Obama's wingman. He said in an interview, quote, "I'm still enjoying what I'm doing. There's still work to be done. I'm still the president's wingman, so I'm there with my boy." That's what he said famously. Is it the duty of the Attorney General to be the president's wingman?
No, I've already described what I think the duty of the Attorney General is.
And in your office, you are then free to act independently of the president. Isn't that true?
That is true, particularly on criminal cases. It's required.
And that's exactly what he has asked you to do. Isn't that right?
Yes.
I have no further time. I yield back. Thank you.
It's well you have no further questions. Your time has expired. Ms. Lofgren.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Attorney General, it's obvious what is happening.